this project is much, much bigger than Aberdeen Football Club. It's the potential to deliver so much for this whole region. And I've said before, the region, the city and the region have gone through a difficult period the last 4 or 5 years through what has happened within the oil sector. The great thing during that period is that we've continued to invest in this region. No, we've now got the Western Bypass. Everyone can see the benefits that that's starting to bring. We're well on the way with the new exhibition centre. The new harbour at Cove is well underway. And this project is another key element of the wider infrastructure that this city region needs for the next, to set it up effectively for the next 20, 30, 40 years. And that's going to, the benefits that are going to flow from that are going to be evident to the whole community.
This is just another important piece in the jigsaw for Derek, isn't it, as he tries to get the football club to where we all want it to be?
Absolutely. No, I think the evidence is there, the progress that's been made in the whole football side over the last five, six years. That has given us the platform, the catalyst, the drive through to enable us to deliver phase one of the project. When that facility's on the ground, that is going to bring massive benefits to the club, massive benefits to the community trust as well.
Yeah, so phase one taken care of, the funding's pretty much all accounted for as well, isn't it?
Phase one funding is all lined up. The decision today is going to enable us to start looking at the sort of three main elements that we've now got to drive forward with for phase two. The first aspect of that is to deal with the outstanding conditions, planning conditions that relate specifically to the stadium element. We'll now get our plans underway in terms of going out there and full consultation exercise with our fans, corporate support, the wider community to make sure that the final design incorporates all the facilities that everyone is looking for. And then the third key element, it allows us to develop our plans for the funding, which is going to be a very substantial challenge. But we can now focus on that with the right sort of background to give us a platform to develop these plans to raise the cash for phase two.
How important is it that fans, the business community, companies, etc., you know, rally around and get behind phase two to, you know, to help you meet what you say quite rightly is going to be a big challenge to raise the money for phase two?
We've had great support to enable us to deliver phase one. The challenge to raise the money for phase two is going to be a multiple of what we've achieved today. But I'd like to thank the fact that we've raised the best part of 12 million to deliver phase one is going to give people the confidence that we'll find a way to raise the funds that's going to be required to deliver phase two.
Again, it gets back to, you know, the manager trying to attract the best young talent and attract the best players. It'll surely be such a positive thing to be able to, you know, show prospective signings, prospective young signings, whatever, you know, around a magnificent facility.
Absolutely. And I think the fact that we haven't had that facility for the last 5, 6 years demonstrates the scale of the job that Derek and his team have done. We've been up there at the top of Scottish football for the last, this is the sixth year now since Derek joined the club. Four out of that, the 5 years finished to date, we finished in second place. He's taken us to seven semi-finals and three finals. And once he's got access to these new facilities, then hopefully that is going to enable us to take that next step.